We are the builders of Dragonfly trimarans. I'm standing here with a Dragonfly 25 Sport, and I will do my best to show you how we set up this boat. And as I just said, this is the sport version, and we also have the touring version. So once in a while, I will comment that there's some few details that are different from the touring versus the sport version, but basically everything is the same, and we will try and of course step in the mast in details and launch the boat, put on the sails, etc. So yeah, stay tuned and we see how it goes. Now we will try and set up the 25 here, and we can only recommend to step the mast while the boat is on land on the trailer. Everything is more stable here. Whereas our 28 version, we also can also rig up on the water, but for the 25, we definitely recommend to step the mast on land with the boat on the trailer. Having said that, now we have a nice sunny day here in Denmark. If you're somewhere with stronger winds, we cannot recommend if you have a strong side wind. So if you have winds more than 15 knots, we recommend, and you have to set the mast, either make sure that the boat face into the wind, or all the wind from behind, from astern. We don't want the sideways winds that can influence the stability of the mast while we step the mast. So maximum 15 knots of wind regularly, and if more winds, face into the wind or the other way around. First thing we do is of course release the spanners from the mast, so the mast is free to move backwards. Before you move the mast backwards, make sure to put on the Windex. If the Windex is put on from our side, the mast is rotating, so we put Windex on as we see here. So it only has one pin. Normally the Windex has two pins to go up when, but because the mast rotates, we only have one pin facing backwards, as you see here. Before you roll the mast backwards, put on the side stays. We have a big, very big shackle here, which is mounted as from our yard on delivery. This big shackle stays here at all times and is secured with a steel cable here. Then we have simply the one side stay here, four stay in the center, and side stay here. You can take this off during transport, and when you receive the boat from us, if it's the first time, these stays will be coiled up inside the boat. But make sure to open this. This is easy to. This is with the key number 14. So just open this one, put the stay on, and secure it. Not hand tight, but very tight. And if you know you will leave it there for a long time, maybe give it some Loctite. And at least every time you take the mast down, check these are tight. So one side stay over here, four stay in the center, another side stay here. And then you can move the mast back, which we will show you now. And as you step the mast, make sure to look up the rigging that this doesn't kink somehow or make funny things. And if you have stepped the mast and you cannot get the force stay on, look up in the rigging, because sometimes this can kink. And if you want to be sure, you can put a small shock cord around here. You don't have to, but just have it in mind that this can kink. Just before rolling the mast backwards to step the mast, make sure to get the halyards pulled down. Many halyards, spinnaker halyards, and jib halyards, because they're difficult to reach where the mast is is pulled backwards and is fixed in this position here. Also, before you roll the mask back, we have this mask pivot fitting, and this one's for the sport version, for the carbon mast. It looks like this, and it has to face like this, not like this, but like this, so the open end is backwards and the solid end is facing forward. So we fix it down here and just put these two bolts in and secure it with a nuts. No tools is required for this. It's just so it doesn't come easy out again. Now this is the pivot point, and then I roll the mast back and put the mast down here. Then I put a pin through here, which I will do now. Holds itself, and we can start building up the rest of the mast raising system. When the boat is folded up like here now, and the boat is new, only when it's new the first season, the boat is designed so the side stays are very tight when the boat is folded. This means now when we step the mast in the first season, we put the side stays on this fitting on the float here, but on the port side, on the left side of the boat, we extend the side stay the first season when we step the mast. So we add this rigging link, which will come later. We have to remove later before we go sailing. So just on the port side, we add this rigging link when we put the side stays on. So now the port size day is ready to step the mast. Let's see how it goes on the other side. For the size day on the starboard side, it's even more simple. So the size day is fitted on the mast. Make sure it doesn't make any turns or kinks. I have checked that now, and then you'll simply put on here on the float. There is only one tang for this, so we just put it here, and now it's fixed. For stepping the mast, I can only recommend best is to be two person. One person can do it like I will do it now, but two persons can easily do it. Three persons okay, but more than three persons don't do it, because it all ends up in a mess, because someone else thought that the other guy did it, and so two, maximum three persons, and one can do it. To support the mast, we have this mast support pole. We have the fitting, this deck fitting that you unscrew. Then you have this thread here. So take this stainless pole from inside the boat and screw it into the deck clockwise, like any other thread, and make sure that these two rings are facing fore and aft, not sideways. It doesn't work. It has to face fore and aft like this. This is for the mast support poles, so you'll see what comes up. Next step is this special U-bolt fitting for the mainsail boom when we step the mast. Here on the front end of the mast, we have
red, both on the touring and the sport version as we see here. So simply just screw in here at the end of the thread clockwise, of course, and make sure to that it goes all the way down. You see the thread comes down here, and it will then the bolt will then push on the rod here, also to make it stronger. So, and make sure that it points this way across the boat. And now I will put the mainsail boom on here, which is next step. Take the mainsail boom and take the front end of the mainsail boom, looks like this, and this goes into here like this, and just put the pin through and this small clevis pin here, and that's it.
Now to support the mast, while stepping the mast, we have these two support posts, a bigger support post, a bigger one and a smaller one. The bigger one is for supporting the mast itself, the smaller one is for supporting the mainsail boom. Make sure when you clip them on that the pin in the spinnaker pole closes, so you are sure it doesn't pop out again. I will fix this one on now.
Mast, we have this 2-to-1 pulley system, which you will find inside the boat, and this is to raise the mast, and just fix it here on the end of the bowsprit where the tack for the where the tack lines for the for the spinnaker, but in this full fitting. This is on the first 35 first dragonflies built. On the later new versions, there will be a steel eye here, so this block will be set here, which will be more logical. But this way is for the first about 35 first boats. This block system, the other end is fixed to this steel eye on the underside of the mainsail boom. This is a strong eye, so I'll just fix it here. The line goes back just over the deck. Just fill the lines through one of the stoppers. Doesn't matter which one, but it's nice to have this line through a stopper. So when you do this operation, you can close the hold the line, which makes it easier if you have to do something underway while you step the mast. The other thing for the mainsail boom is the spinnaker halyard I have prepared. The spinnaker halyard has to go free in one line to the top, and at the end of the boom there is one small shackle for don't use that, that's only to hold the mainsail while moored in the marina, but use the big shackle here for the outhaul of the mainsail boom, for the mainsail. So just fix it on the big shackle here. You can also fix this before you put the boom at this position. And, now I can lift up the mainsail boom, and you will see it all looks, everything comes into place now. Now it all looks, makes more sense. This is the pulley to pull up the whole thing. The spinnaker halyard I will secure in a minute, and this one supports the boom while or during the operation. Now it's important that the boom is not just upright, it has to go a little bit backwards, otherwise the mainsail boom will not clear the pull pin forward. So just make sure that the mainsail boom is about a foot, 50 centimeters back in the top, about 10 degrees. I'm doing it on my own now, but again, two persons is best, but now I can just... This is the life of the pulley. It goes through the clutch, and the clutch is holding the pulley now. And now I take the spinnaker halyard. The spinnaker halyard is now clear. And the spinnaker halyard I tie into the turret buckle here. The position I want. So just tie the spinnaker halyard here, because now the spinnaker halyard is tied to the mast. Normally you should think you could put the spinnaker halyard through here, but the spinnaker halyard will shave here and will pull some, and it will also put some wrong stress on the pivot system, so it's best to secure the spinnaker halyard on the mast itself. Can be a turnbuckle or the gooseneck fitting, doesn't matter. But yeah, we can raise the mast now. I will now step the mast, and while you step the mast, just check that the side stays do not entangle in the back end of the boat, and that the side stays do not twist. It's very important. The side stays are willing to twist, especially here it can twist and turn around, and also up in the rigging. So once the mast is up and the fore stay is not long enough, just look up into the mast and check if the rigging links on the side stays are okay, or if they have and then again, make sure to face the wind and go downwind if you have more than 15 knots of wind. And to raise the mast is simply to winch it up, which you will see in a minute. And just winch it up slowly. Take your time. There's no rush. In the beginning, it needs more force because the mast is almost horizontal. But as the mast comes up, check the side stays are okay, and when the mast is almost up, it's nice to take one of the back stays to sort of give it to hold the mast a bit backwards, as you pull, the rest of it doesn't come up too fast. Now I'm doing it alone, so perfect for this is two persons, so one person will hold the fore stay, otherwise one person can do it. Make sure that when the mast is on the trailer, or when you step the mast on the trailer, that you have a spanner on the front of the boat on the bow. Here, now it's on the other side, so the boat doesn't sort of pivot fore and aft. And also that you have spanners each side on the hull, so the boat doesn't step on the trailer. If you leave the boat on the hard, so on land with on the trailer, make sure if you have strong winds to secure the and the mast to something more solid. If the wind comes from the side with a station mast, there's a lot of wind there, so secure the mast with a header tree if necessary. It's just I've never seen it before. You never know. Thank you. this line is sort of hand tight, not over tight, because it puts a lot of stress on the whole system, but just well tight. And now we put the force day on. The force day can turn this way or this way. This is wrong. This opening have to face backwards so the furling line can enter from the backside. Now I'll put the force day on. So just on here and the pin ball here and a split pin here. I can only recommend that after this is set, put some rigging tape around to secure the pin, so some kind of Cosero spinnaker sheet doesn't open the pin here. As well with the size days, just put some rigging tape around these locking pins.